Supreme Court's big intervention as far as the Chandigarh mayoral polls are concerned. Remember, the Aam Aadmi Party candidate had moved the Supreme Court, challenging the High Court order, because the High Court had said that, well, it will not reconsider holding elections again. But the Supreme Court has said that all records of the mayoral polls should be kept safe. And in fact, the Chief Justice of India, D.Y. Chandrachud, made a big remark. He said that it's like a murder of democracy and we will not allow democracy to be murdered. So what essentially had happened was that 8 of the Aam Aadmi Party's votes were declared invalid and not a single vote of the BJP was declared invalid. Mohammed Ghazali is joining us live on the phone line. So Ghazali, this of course is a big relief for the Aam Aadmi Party Congress alliance there as far as the mayoral polls are concerned, because they had said that these elections are invalid and in a sense it's against democracy to uphold that verdict.
It's a big victory in the sense the way Supreme Court has come down hard on the electoral officer, or say the presiding officer, saying that in the video it was visible that how he sort of damaged the votes by writing it on the ballot paper. And that was the exact point of contention or the allegation which was on the Supreme Court, on the presiding officer in the petition, that on camera, on video, since the proceedings were all recorded, it was very evident that what he was writing on those votes was never made visible, was never shared with anyone by the presiding officer, that why those votes were declared illegal. And this is exactly why the Supreme Court said that we will not let the murder of democracy like this. And the Supreme Court in its comments have come down hard on the tough on the presiding officer, as well as the Supreme Court order also mentioned that the budget session will not proceed as scheduled on tomorrow. And until next Monday, when the next hearing comes up in the Supreme Court, then perhaps the Supreme Court will come up with more clear instructions or the order regarding whether a re-election should happen for the post of mayor or not.
Absolutely, Ghazali. And in fact, as you said, the Supreme Court has come down heavily on the returning officer as well, saying that there should be, you know, an investigation, there should be a legal probe that should be launched against the returning officer as well, perhaps, you know, validating the point that the Aam Aadmi Party candidate was making.
Yes, and the Supreme Court says that that in the video it is very clear that how he's stamping with the vote. The Supreme Court also says that the sanctity of the electoral process should be kept intact, and action should be taken against the presiding officer. So besides this, since the observations have been made by the Supreme Court in first hearing today, perhaps more detailed instructions will come in the next hearing when the Supreme Court will see in more detail, since the court has also asked concerned officers to look for, to preserve all the records, be it the ballot papers, be it the votes, or those voting papers on which all the mayors, all the councillors had voted or put their agreement or disagreement or kind of voted for that ballot paper. All has been asked, all the records have been asked to be kept preserved for till the next hearing.
Suri Ghazali, and what's really big is that the Supreme Court has stalled the budget session as well till the next hearing. The next hearing is on the 12th of February. So that is, in a sense, a big victory for the Aam Aadmi Party Congress there in Punjab, in Chandigarh. But Ghazali, just recap for our viewers what actually happened that day, because the mayoral polls are, in a sense, a bit complicated. But what was the Aam Aadmi Party's charge? They essentially said that, well, their votes were declared invalid and that was arbitrarily done.
See, as far as the entire polls are concerned, it was very evident from day one, since the dates were announced that on January 30th, the polling will be done. The numbers were on the side of the India Alliance, or say the Congress Aam Aadmi Party Alliance, for this poll. They were having 20 mayors with them, and to cross the magic figure, which was 19. So as far as the numbers were concerned, it was a foregone conclusion that if no cross-voting happens, then perhaps Congress and Aam Aadmi Party will have their mayor in the Chandigarh Municipal Corporation. But on the very day of the polling, what we saw was that around 8 votes were declared invalid. Till the end of the day, neither the presiding officer nor anybody from the corporation came out to declare or share that why those votes were declared invalid. And what was the charge or what was the allegation of the Congress and Aam Aadmi Party councillors was that all those 8 votes which have been declared invalid are of the councillors from the India Alliance. Perhaps only the India Alliance councillors didn't know how to vote legally or didn't know how to vote in a way all the councillors had to.
perhaps all the remaining BJP councillors knew how to vote exactly the way it should have been. And this is the charge, saying that the presiding officer is the same presiding officer due to whom the elections were postponed for the very first time on 18 January, saying he was ill. But despite he being ill, the very next time when the High Court announced the date, Mr. Masih was again appointed the presiding officer. He is the nominated councillor. He also happens to be the member of BJP minority cell in Chandigarh. So these were the allegations, saying that perhaps the presiding officer deliberately or in a prejudiced way favored the BJP and declared all the votes invalid without giving any proper reason.
Absolutely, Ghazali, and we are playing that video on our screen as well that the Supreme Court is citing. But just looking at the Supreme Court's observations and strong remarks against the presiding officer, now this also in a sense raises a larger issue, because a similar thing happened here in the national capital as well. After the Aam Aadmi Party swept the MCD polls, I clearly remember how the role of the pro tem speaker, how he was appointed, how the presiding officer was appointed, and how he managed to sort of kept the mayoral polls on a cliffhanger. That, in a sense, is a redux of what happened in Delhi as well. So, you know, in a sense, a larger question on the role of the presiding officer in such cases.
Oh, yes. And this is, in some sense, regardless of who are the parties in this case, the way the Chief Justice of India has reacted to after looking at the video, perhaps that was very evident on the day of the voting. The entire video of the presiding officer writing something on the ballot papers was splashed across the screen. The Congress and Aam Aadmi Party jointly held a press conference. The video was all over the social media. And anybody from a prima facie position, it appeared as if that he was tampering with those ballot papers without giving an actual reason that why have you declared those votes invalid. And perhaps the CGI has taken note of it, saying that how it amounts to the murder of democracy. He won't let it happen in future, and also to freeze all the records as of now, to preserve all the records. It somehow also raises the larger question on the electoral process of the which was undertaken on that particular day for the post of mayor. Because after the mayor was elected, due to this 8 votes getting invalid, that election was not just for the post of mayor. The election was to be held for the 2 other posts of senior deputy mayor and deputy mayor. And once the mayor was declared that it will be the BJP candidate who has won the mayoral polls, the Congress and our councillors walked out of the corporation office. And despite their walking out, the deputy mayor and senior deputy mayor's post was also sort of the election was conducted and unanimously they won. So now perhaps after this judgment, even their election, the process through which the senior deputy mayor and deputy mayor have been elected unanimously in the absence of Congress and half councillors voting there will also come under its scrutiny.